finally here. Wessex Bass Trumpet. You know, I don't know if they're going to get any more of these, so if you want one, you better get one now. Because once I ordered this one, it was the last lacquered piston valve bass trumpet. Oh, you know, silver would probably be a lot better. So, I'm going to just kind of review this thing. You get this nice case. It's pretty much the same style case that all the good companies are using. You know, it's kind of like a modern Besson case. What do you get? Well, in this here top pouch, you get, I don't know, whatever this is. Get extra springs and what do you call them, valve guides, whatever, sure. You get this bag, which actually doesn't come in the case when you receive the item. What's in the bag? The hat, a cleaning cloth. Oh boy, gotta have microfiber cloth with the logo so everyone knows that you bought a Wessex. And can I get it? A pencil. Thanks. And a bottle of valve oil, which actually I'm really grateful for this because I'm almost out of valve oil. All I've got left is the valve oil that I put powdered graphite in. And well, you know what? I don't want to put that in everything. Also, you get, count them, two straps so that you can convert this into a backpack, which, sure, why not? That's kind of cool, I guess. Not really how I would want to carry this around. It's kind of narrow for that, but that's all right. And then, looky there, ain't that a beauty? Comes with a I don't know, but what the hell do you call this? Wessex 6 3/4 C. Round rim, deep as a 6.5 AL, but small back bore, and much bigger than a 6.5 A. I can't even play this on anything, it's that big. I guess if I had, like, I don't know, bass trombone with a small shank or something? No. Whatever, nice of the case to include a spot for the Shoki 40B that you better be buying if you're going to play this as a bass trumpet. And now the horn includes the quality control tag. Very nice. You know what, I think I'll just leave that on there. How about this? Look at this thing. Isn't this wonderful? What a work of art. You know, from the side profile, it looks kind of goofy, but when you're looking down it, it's actually pretty cool. Alright, so I want to talk about the slides here, because these are hard to see in photos. You do have independent tuning from your thumb saddle. You have an extra main slide here that shamefully does not have a finger hook or anything. I really wish it did. This would be awesome if it had a kicker. I believe the Bach bass trumpet that this is based on, this would be a dual bore slide. So you'd have three tuning slides. On this model, it's not, so whatever. And again, beautiful rose brass bell, which they call gold brass for whatever reason, I don't care. And rose brass lead pipe, because China loves them some rose brass lead pipes on everything. Even if that's the only rose brass in the horn, you're going to get that. Whatever. Looks good. Valves are nice. Finish isn't perfect, but, you know, I ain't crying. Yeah, look at that, man. I can't get over how wonderful this thing looks. I'm pretty excited to have it. But, as I'm going to show you, I'm not excited to have it because of it being a bass trumpet. In fact, let me get a mouthpiece that will actually work on here somewhat. Here's my NG12C. Maybe something that might actually remotely play on here. Yeah, also this thing constantly fills the spit. Spit valves are not that useful. It's pretty much like a French horn. You get a little spit in it, dump it. Spit, dump, spit, dump. Feels like you're doing it nonstop. Alright, so, yeah, you're getting the idea. Let's take a little intermission to ask the really important question. Should this be called a bass trumpet? What's a bass trumpet? Is this a bass trumpet? Blah, blah, blah. Well, if you ask the rotary guys, they'll tell you it's not a bass trumpet because it ain't big enough. If you ask the trumpet fanfare ensemble guys, they'll tell you this ain't a bass trumpet, it's a tenor trumpet. And if you ask the guys who made the original horn that this was copied off of, it's a bass trumpet. I guess it's a bass trumpet then, huh? Good enough for me. Is it really a trumpet? Yeah, good enough. I can almost get that pedal tone, but I feel like maybe it's just because it's so raspy I'm pulling it up in the tune. If I really lock it in, it's super flat, so whatever, good enough. Now let's doodle some more on here. Me struggling to get an E above the scale on a trumpet with a 12C. This is not a bass trumpet. No, sir. Let me tell you what this is. This is something that hasn't existed for a very long time, other than as reproductions that nobody ever played. Now we're talking. This is an Egger Salzburg Immer Series SI5 Baroque Trumpet Mouthpiece. Check this out. Playing this all night, my lips are a little tired. Yeah, I'm not as studly as the guys from the 16 and 1700s, but it works. This is a lot of fun. Here's how you play this thing. The heck with it being a bass trumpet, the long trumpet is back. So, should you buy one of these? Well, if you got $800 burning a hole in your pocket, or you just want to build some credit really fast, yeah, you should. Get you one of these, or, you know, whatever size you think is going to work for you anyways. I don't know that, like, I'm probably going to get another Baroque trumpet mouthpiece at some point if I don't figure out how to adjust to this one. Because, yeah, I'm kind of struggling on this thing, but, oh my goodness, it sounds amazing, doesn't it? Sounds good to me anyways. Maybe the camera's not picking up how awesome it is. Let me try to play something. If I can. I don't know. Gotcha. Hold on. the way, slotting on this is, it's not the worst I've ever played, but it's a whole nother animal. Okay. Ears. You need them. Mouthpiece is pretty hard. Might want to try one with a rounder rim, because it's not like it's helping the slotting that much anyways. But yeah, you hear that? That sounds pretty cool, doesn't it? Not bad, pretty jazzy. I like it. I'm probably going to be practicing on this quite a bit, see if I can lock down the technique on this. I think it's worth it. I really do. This is a functional instrument. I think it's capable. I just don't think it's a bass trumpet. 460 bore is way too small. You can't play tenor at that size, not with a full-size mouthpiece. I can go down on this and it will, you know, it'll kind of, I don't know, rumble a little bit down there. B flat trumpet. Haha, I got you there, didn't I? Well, yeah, and then you squeal out some like triple G on me. I think it is possible to play, you know, as high as a B flat trumpet on this. I can't do it yet. Maybe eventually I can. I haven't mastered this mouthpiece design yet, but I think it's there. Like, I've been able to squeal out some high notes on here before. Maybe just for the hell of demonstrating it, I'll try one. I'm a little tired at this point, but I'll give it a shot. Need it, sir. The horns aren't running out of range. I am. Some things that would be, you know, nice, make this a little better. If you got the guts to get a kicker installed on this main slide, that'd help. Give you more options. Because, yeah, third slide isn't long enough. It's only, what, here to here. So, you're not going to be able to put a kicker on that. Thumb saddle, you know, that's alright if you're, you know, using first valve. You know, if you're not, then what good's that do? Yeah, and don't try this with a, like, just normal trumpet mouthpiece. Don't do that. I'm not going to show you what happens. I haven't even bothered trying it. I just know I've tried other instruments, that kind of combo, and the super round rim and the shallow cup like that. You know, it's shallow for this. That doesn't work. It's just like when you put a French horn mouthpiece in a smaller instrument. You know, just it refuses to work right. It'll do the same thing. You know, you put that on this and you won't be able to pick off anything. This, you know, I can at least pick off notes somewhat. You know, it's hard, but it's doable. Just gotta be able to hear it. And my B flat ears are a little iffy. I'm a lot better in F. But hopefully someone will see this and they'll think, wow, that's a really stupid idea, I'm going to try that, because I want to hear somebody else do this, somebody who's a better musician than I am, because I think this is capable. I really do. So internet, I've put it out there, give her a whack, please.